Hello friends, I am Dr. Aguilar, Assistant Professor in Department of Geography, Himalayan University. Today, we can discuss about the profit maximization theory by August Losch. This August Losch is a German economist. He propounded this theory on 1954. He opposed the concept of least cost location theory by Weber. He says that Weber has given more importance to transportation and labor cost. But here in this profit maximization theory, he says that profit has a role to play in locating the industry. This theory says that the main objective of an entrepreneur is to maximize his profit. For maximizing his profit, what he wants to do is to find out a best suitable place for his industry. And the Losch has of the view that for identifying this best suitable place, an entrepreneur should consider the total cost of production and the consumption rate of his product in various locations and identify the best suitable place to locate his industry. Now, we can understand what are the assumptions made by Losch in establishing their theory. Here, he assumes that there should be a homogeneous plane with even distribution of raw material, and the character of the people should also be homogeneous, like means they have the same taste, knowledge, etc. And the population should be evenly distributed along the homogeneous plane, and there should be absence of economic discrimination. That means everyone should have same economic condition. The fourth assumption he has made is about transportation cost. He says that the transportation cost is or should be uniform throughout the homogeneous plane, and the transportation cost will increase from the city center to the outer space. The next assumption is that there should be agriculture self-sufficiency, and there should not be an excess production in agriculture, as if there is excess in agriculture, there is a chance of disturbing the economic condition of the locality. For that, he has taken some more assumptions, like there is a perfect monopoly in that region. That means the production center is dependable or is dependent by some market only, and this market or firm will not allow a new firm to enter, and this location should be suitable for both the producer and the consumer. And he also says that this area should have the provision of getting the same product from different other source, but because of the present condition or present economic condition, the people is depending on this production center for their activity. See, as stated earlier, there are two factors which influence the location of an industry, according to Losch. The first one is the total cost of production, and the second one is the demand. Now we can look how this demand is influenced by the change in price. The first picture, that is A, you can see that at price 1, the quantity demanded is C1. And when the price is increased to P2, the quantity demanded come to C2. So there is an inverse proportion between the price and the demand. When the price is increasing, the demand will decrease, and when the price is decreasing, the demand will increase. Here, Losch considered this point in his theory also. For that, he explained this concept in the form of demand cone. He says that as the people move from the city center, the price of the commodity will be increases. This is because of the addition of the transportation cost. Thus, the demand of the product or quantity demanded will come down. In the picture B, or second picture, you can see that at the sender, the price is P1 and the quantity demand is C1. When the people are moving out of the city, at P2, you can see that the demand has come down to C2. But at certain point, the price of the commodity will increase in such a way that people can't able to afford that price. That you can see at P3, the quantity demanded, that is C3, is zero. So he says that this is the influencing area of that particular industry. Now we can look how the industrial growth occurs in a place. There are three phases of development as per Losch. Before going to understand these phases, you should understand certain facts. The first one is regarding the profit. We know that the profit is the difference between the total cost of production and the price we are putting on that product. And it is also stated earlier that when the price increases, the demand decreases. So there should be a certain margin for profit. The entrepreneur should consider this margin to avoid the entry of new firm. If he is trying to establish more profit, or he try for more profit, another firm or new firm will enter into his place. There are multiple location or places you can see the demand of a particular product is maximum. For the entrepreneur, he should study it separately and understand which is the most suitable place to get the maximum profit for his or her product. This area or location is considered as the optimum location for establishing an industry. After identifying an optimum location, the entrepreneur establishes his firm in that particular location. After establishing that particular industry, other firms or market will start growing around this industry for their own individual profit. Thus, they develop an extensive area of profitable operational space. This was represented by Losch in the form of a circular pattern. Even though there occur expansion of this profitable operational space later on, there remains some unserved space or voids. Thus, a maldistribution occurs in this profitable operational space, which can be used for new firms to establish themselves there. This is the pictorial representation of a profitable operational space. You can see number of circles, and in each circle there is a production center, and there are number of markets which are depending this production centers. But beyond the circle, you can see number of firms which are answered by any of these production centers. And these firms or market is the target for new firms to establish their production centers. In the third phase, you can see the already established firms will try to expand their service centers and thereby try to reduce or narrow down the unserved space. But even though they are trying, there are number of spaces which are unserved. So this will become the target of a new entrepreneur. The new firms constructed at these hinterlands or the unserved space also try to expand their influence area for getting more profit. So there you can see a competition between the new firm and already established firm. Thus, the circular pattern of the influencing area of production center will be disrupted and a new hexagonal pattern is formed. This is a pictorial representation of how change in price influences the market condition. Here you can see two markets. One is market A and one is market B. And the outer circle is the area of influence by market A and market B. See, at price P1, market A has a quantity demand of AQ1 and AQ1 dash. That much of area is served by market A at price 1. And at the same price, the market B, that is at P1 dash, the market B serves the area BQ1 and BQ1 dash. But at certain stage, the market A has raised the price to P2, thus reducing its influencing area to AQ2 and AQ2 dash. So this much of area has been deducted from the influencing area for market A. At the same time, the market B has the old price level, that is P1. So people try to buy the same product from market B. Thus, this will increase the market area or the influencing area of market B. Now we can see how hexagon pattern is developing in Losch theory of profit maximization. At the first stage, you can see a circular pattern in which there is a production center at the center and around which number of market which is purely depending this production center for the profit. In the second stage, this market will try to establish their influence in more areas and thereby reducing the unserved spaces or the voids. And in the third stage, we know that new firms also try to establish their industries or production centers in the unserved spaces, and thereby you can see the competition become high, thereby reducing the space. He says that, or Losch says that, hexagon can fill a plane completely while the circle it is not possible. So he chose this hexagon to fill the complete plane of service. Now we can discuss about the demerit or criticism against this theory. The first one is the homogeneous character of the people. It is criticized that The character of the people may vary from person to person, and so it is not possible to bring homogeneous character in a theory. The second criticism is that Losch ignored the importance of technological development. The third criticism is Losch ignored the importance of cost of raw material and change in wage rate. These are the two factors which influence the total cost of production. Another criticism is that the optimum situation, which is mentioned in this theory, is suitable only for agriculture sector. And the last or the final criticism is that this theory is not suitable for every condition. See, even now we are considering the same factors, that is the total cost of production and the quantity demand of a particular commodity for establishing an industry at a particular place. This is the importance of Losch's theory of profit maximization. Thank you very much for hearing this lecture.